John, another controversy that's just come out is that there's a book that's going to come out May 5th that accuses the Clintons of giving favors to foreign interests while cashing in on donations to their foundation and speaking fees. The book was circulated to members of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee.
Well, some members of the
we were told, I don't know who, I haven't read the book.
Some foreign relations.
And also,
it sounds like maybe just the Republican members of the foreign, maybe just because Marco Rubio and Rand Paul happen to be members of the Senate Foreign Relations Committee.
It was not circulated to Democrats?
Not to the best of my knowledge.
Well, also, the New York Times, the Washington Post, and Fox News cut a deal where they were going to work with the author, and I've never quite heard of something like this, to follow up on any charges.
Yeah.
Is this of concern to you?
Well, look, let's take a look at this book, and, you know, it's kind of par for the course in politics these days. It's a book that's written by a former Bush operative who's a reporter for that august news institution, Breitbart.com, or has been in the past. He's cherry-picked information that's been disclosed and woven a bunch of conspiracy theories about it. The facts, there's nothing new about. The conspiracy theories, I guess we'll get to judge when we read the book. But
are you surprised the New York Times cut a deal with him to follow up on the charges?
I think they have to be asking themselves, is that kind of appropriate behavior? They have a lot of reporters. They can take a look at it, too.
Same with the Post.
But, you get them in here and ask them that question. I think this is this is what it is. It's we've seen it before. There have been a couple others earlier of places where the perception of fairness is belied by the cherry picking of facts, the weaving of conspiracy theories. And I want you to remember something, Al. The only reason those facts are out there is because the Clinton Foundation has put all that out. They've gone beyond any foundation of like size that's operating globally in public disclosure. I am very knowledgeable and very proud of the work they're doing around the world, whether it's HIV/AIDS, whether it's providing development assistance to people in Africa, whether it's trying to rebuild Haiti. They're doing tremendous work. And I think that all the Clintons are proud of what the foundation's been able to do.